soon. Hi guys.
Hi Mambo.
Etisen.
Sateni.
Welcome to the Forbidden Fruit
Channel. Mataka kusema family here.
Welcome to the Kenyan YouTube family
here. So guys, I have amazing YouTubers with me today. They will introduce themselves and I will link their channels below. You can check them out. They are big YouTubers, brah. You gotta check them out. Yes, they know.
Go ahead. African Tigress, you already know me, the one and only African Tigress.
Okay, Domaris Jenga.
And hi guys, my name is Ruth Kim and I'm happy to be here and I love you guys. Subscribe to my channel.
Yes. So guys, they are all YouTubers. I'm going to ask them a few questions and I am happy to have them subscribe to their channels, check their content out, and thank you for watching this video with us. So now I'm gonna go straight away to ask African Tigress. She's a vlogger, a travel vlogger. So she travels around Africa. I want her to tell you the experience of traveling around, what she's seen around Africa that's not in Kenya, and you know, what she's seen in Kenya that's not out there, the merits and demerits. Go ahead.
Oh, well, where do I start with? I've been to a lot of places, even before I started a YouTube channel. And, well, basically Africa, you'll always find something common that cuts across maybe our welcoming nature. You'll get it in each and every African. Trust me, there's no African country that you will go and not feel welcome.
True.
Yeah, you'll always be welcomed in each and every country. The only differences would be like maybe food. Yeah, maybe the food would be different. But well, traveling is fun because it opens your eyes. It makes you see the world through different people's eyes. You know, you get to understand why some countries are more developed than the others. You get to understand challenges that you face. You get to, like me as a Kenyan, I get to appreciate the fact that in Kenya we have good Wi-Fi. Good internet speeds and all
it's
that.
It's actually even better than the one in Germany, guys. Kenya has the best internet.
So like, traveling has made me appreciate that about Kenya. Honestly, sometimes when I travel, I get kind of depressed. Well, especially when I meet challenges, like you've done content, but you're not able to upload. Sometimes you start uploading a video in the morning, it gets at the evening, and any slight mistake, it fails. So that means that video has to wait to the next day.
Yeah. Oh my God. So where would you say in Africa so far that you've traveled, which is the most developed country?
Most developed? Kenya. Kenya to have me. Kenya is like really good. I love Kenya because Kenya is very, 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 very vibrant.
I thought Rwanda is developed. Actually, I was about to say
Rwanda. No, I don't think about the development. I think Rwanda, when you visited Rwanda, I liked it because Rwanda is so clean.
Yeah.
Rwanda is so organized, like in their traveling, you know, the
Honestly, for me, one thing that stood out, even besides the cleanliness and the organized transport and all that, because there are lots of other countries that have that organized transport, cleanliness, but they don't have security. So I loved one thing that stood out for me in Rwanda was the security. Like, security for me is like very, very, very important. Because there are so many countries, you'd agree with me, there are so many countries that are so clean with good transport. But you cannot walk around at 3 a.m.
So Rwanda was very secure.
Rwanda was very, very secure. The police are friendly. So like, that's one thing that really stood out in Rwanda for me.
I like that totally.
And Burundi. Burundi, I love the beach.
The beach?
That is in the city. I wish, no, like, you see, if we had a beach, it's like having a beach in Nairobi, you know?
It's in the city.
They recently moved the capital city from Bujumbura to some place called Gitega or something. But like, still, like, it has not totally moved because it was in February. So like, Bujumbura is the capital city of Burundi. Could you imagine if we had a beach in Nairobi? My goodness.
Hey, tungefanya kazi. All right, I love that. So guys, you can visit the countries as well. Go check her channel. Like, she's visited very many countries. You can check where she's gone and see the experiences, you know. I'm not gonna tell you all about it because I'm trying to make you go watch her channel. So I have Damaris here. Damaris, wewe mwenye umeka Kenya uhami. What do you love about
Okay. I've never like really thought about what I love about Kenya, like mm-hmm. because I'm like I got this is where I'll always be regardless of everything. Mm-hmm. But I love the concept of like good weather. It's so hot and the sun. You can visit Mombasa and everything. Mm-hmm. Nairobi. Apart from at times it gets so sunny and at times it gets so cold. Mm-hmm. But on good days, I'd say averagely we have like very good weather.
Yeah.
And as she said, you have like good Wi-Fi and some at very affordable like and cheap things. Mm-hmm. And I there's still so many other things I dislike about Kenya, but yeah, like for
like okay,
for example,
Kenya.
Being told you can't vlog here, you know, like what I dislike about Kenya.
No, let me tell you, in some places it's worse. Kenya is better.
Kenya is better,
you know,
actually,
like in places like
in places like village markets and all and they allow you, but it's just in malls, but it's also for the security. You have to understand it's
and
for the
actually,
security.
In Germany, and so it's, you're not supposed to vlog people's faces. Well, sometimes I wonder if you're supposed to vlog up to be
No, you no, sir, actually, you put the camera like this
to just face you.
Yeah, when you put it at this angle, it does not capture the other people who are walking.
Yeah.
Did they say captures? You know, people will make fun. It does not capture.
English teachers, Musianza, by the way.
It does not capture other people who are next to you. So you put the camera at this angle and then you walk. Yeah. It won't capture any other person.
Okay.
Unless they put you. On your camera, and that's the
fault. Sense.
One thing I also think Kenya has, mm-hmm. I think it has opportunities. Like after I have interacted and watched a lot of like people's content, mm-hmm. I have come to appreciate. As much as we still struggle in some places and unemployment and everything, mm-hmm. we still have opportunities, especially entrepreneurship opportunities, and so many of these things like. Many places you can pitch your ideas and get like people investing in your business and everything.
Yeah.
So I believe Kenya has like these great opportunities that you can come here, invest, do something, and make a living.
Yeah. So guys, Ruth is from Germany. She's a Kenyan YouTuber, but she's from Germany. So she's going to tell us her experience in Germany compared to Kenya. She has not been here for how long now?
Since 2010. I've been visiting, but I went to Germany officially since 2010.
So what are the differences you've seen here and there?
Actually, the differences, like I don't know if they're even differences, because I went to Germany when I was so young and naive. I was used to, like, my mom used to do everything for me.
Yeah.
And when I went there, the first thing I had to learn was to be independent, mm-hmm. to learn how to do things on my own.
Yeah.
Because back in Kenya, my mom used, people used to think for me. Let me just say people used to think for me. I never
You were babied a lot.
Yeah, what am I going to eat? What am I going to do? When you get there, you have to decide what you want to do with your life.
Yeah.
So I had to mature up, mm-hmm. and think what I want to do with my life, because when you get there, people tell you so many things. When you get there, especially if you're young, mm-hmm. some people will tell you, if you want to stay here, get married, get a baby, get a white husband and all that. Yeah. But you have to go back and think, take yourself for a committee.
Yeah.
Mwenyewe. You decide what you want to do.
So you think in Kenya we are a bit babied than out there? You very much
me. I think if I continued staying here in Kenya, mm-hmm. I would have like taken time to like kufikiria.
I actually feel the same way. Mm-hmm. I feel that way as well.
Because the moment you're there, mm-hmm. you're the one who you'll have to work to find food, mm-hmm. a shelter, everything.
Yeah.
And when you're back here at home, unajua.
Everything is sorted. Yeah.
Do I need an apartment?
What do you think about healthcare compared to Kenya?
I think it's not even comparable, because
Germany is better.
Germany is better. Like each and every person living in Germany is insured. If you can't pay for your own insurance, the government is going to pay for the insurance. So mm-hmm. and actually, even if we invite people to come and visit, we have to pay the insurance.
Oh wow, okay, that's amazing.
So medical insurance is the, I always say it's the best. And mm-hmm. one more thing is the education. Education is in Germany is like free. It's free. You don't have to sell your soul mm-hmm. to go to school.
Okay.
I have a question. Mm-hmm. What do you miss most about Kenya?
What I miss about Kenya?
Yeah, when you're in Germany, what do you miss most about Kenya?
Like everything.
What's everything?
It's funny, but I miss everything. You know, like the togetherness that people have. Like in Germany, I don't
just feeling at home.
Yeah, in Germany we are so lonely.
Mm-hmm. I get you.
We don't even have friends. I've talked about friendship in my almost all my videos.
No, but I think because since you travel in Africa, Africans are more receptive, you know.
Exactly.
They take in people very easily. But once you travel out there in different continents, you find, no offense to anyone, but there's a bit of racism. Or if it's not racism, there's a bit of some kind of, you know, before anyone accepts you very fast, they take their time and they might end up even not accepting you. So you find yourself like feeling very much at home in Kenya than anywhere else.
Have you ever felt racially profiled?
Yeah, especially if you're working in a group of black people. A random white guy will come from nowhere and ask you guys, are we here? Are we in Africa or what?
Oh, wow.
Really?
Yeah, but normally people don't do that. But utasikia tu mtu with a very low sound of voice.
Yeah.
Are we here in Africa or what? And one thing I would like to tell you guys, if you get the opportunity to go out there, take advantage of the many chances, especially if you go to Germany. They have so many open opportunities.
True.
They take you in, you can go to school, you can go to the university, you can do whatever you want as long as you're legal.
Yeah, true.
And if you're here in Kenya, you want to travel anywhere abroad, if you go to the agencies, sometimes they don't tell you exactly what's waiting
what
for
expecting.
You out there.
True.
I've met people who came in Germany and they don't even have papers. They are just
like
there
that.
Because the agent or agency, because the agent said after 2 weeks you're going to find a job. You get there, they tell you utajipanga. So you end up seeking asylum because you didn't inform yourself when you're here in Kenya.
Yeah.
Inform yourself, guys, before you travel anywhere.
So guys, you can go check out on her channel. She talks about her life in Germany. You can get to learn more about Germany and, you know, everything they have, their healthcare, insurance. Talk about it, lifestyle. She talks about it in her channel. So thank you so much for tuning in. Go check them out and check what they do. All of them, they're amazing people. So thank you. Tell a friend to
subscribe.
Watch this video.
Yes. Yay.